22, come Dulwich. And Zigru, is he there? Dulwich College, the dynasty continues.
Blake Edwards.
Well, a very good morning to you and welcome to another big day of NatWest Schools Cup Finals Rugby. Great to have your company on our live stream on englandrugby.com, wherever you're watching, as we build up to our first game of four of the day. And we are starting with Beths Grammar School against Pocklington School. It's the under-15 NatWest Schools Cup Bowl Final. And we're live from Six Ways Stadium. Of course, some of the finals are taking place at Twickenham tomorrow as well, our second day. But today, it's all about Six Ways and our finals, which start here with the bowl final. And here's the Beths Grammar School team. Tom Seeley, Liam Sheese, who is one of the twins. We've got two sets of twins in Beths Grammar School. Harry McGurk, Joshua Joseph Leander, and then Nathan Grant. Nathaniel Ticehurst, who of course is twinned with the scrum half Lawrence, Finn Nichols and Daniel Adamola, the skipper. And then in the backs, Lawrence Ticehurst, as we said, Ted Burrows, Ishmael Mansere, Dan Mitchell, James Powell, Lucas Nathan and Spike Weeks. Jake Eideman is the coach of the side. He's the teacher of PE at the school in his first year of looking after the side. And the Pocklington team. Edward Hasdell, Archie Raper and John Wright, the front row. Michael Smith is the skipper. Then Freddie Bickley-Parton. Cameron Adams, Afonso Spencer and Henry Hughes make up the back row. At halfback, Harry Jones and Louis Sanguin. And then in a couple of late changes to the side, Ben Maycock is at 11. Sam Dyson has moved into 12 for Ben McNamara, who is the son of the ex-England coach, England Rugby League coach, Steve McNamara. And Ben got injured at the weekend. And then we have Harry Matthews at outside centre, Edward James and William Dare at fullback. A look at both benches then. Martin Ryan, Niall Sheese there, the other Sheese twin. Mohamed Mohamed, Ryan Nayathi, Dan Cunningham, Josh Howard and Jerry Adegoke and Tom Duggleby, Oscar Hawksworth, William Watts, Alfie Hall, Harry Cowan, Cobby Fofi and Tom Quirk are in the Pocklington School replacements lineup. Pocklington, perhaps the bigger name in schools rugby then, which is delighted to say that joining me in co-commentary is Dave Rogers. And, well, Dave, you're alongside me for much of the Roslyn Park Sevens last week. We continue with schoolboy rugby at 15s, and we're looking forward to this one.
Oh, certainly are. What a very, very exciting time this time of year is for schools rugby. As you mentioned, Roslyn Park last week. Of course, the other finals at Twickenham tomorrow. But today, what an opportunity for these youngsters on this playing surface. Of course, it must feel so good coming off the back of a very rough winter to play on a guaranteed surface. Even those who played at Roslyn Park last week, we didn't have the best of the conditions, but it's foggy here today, but it's dry and we're all set to go.
Referee for this one is Andy Wigley, as Pocklington's Sam Dyson gets us underway with the kick downfield, and Beths with an early carry, and it's a solid carry to set them up with their first platform as the ball comes back to Lawrence Ticehurst, carried in well by his brother Nathaniel. Scrum half looking for the ball, trying to signal to the referee that it wasn't coming back, but it does eventually. And, oh well, almost a little error at the back from William Dare. Just went backwards, so referee's happy enough with it. And you could see Harry Jones, the scrum half, looking with open palms to the referee for a decision. And he got it. Interesting chatting to Niall Temple, who was giving me a few extra little bits of information ahead of the game. And he was telling me that as far as Pocklington are concerned, they haven't got the speediest of men out the back. They can handle themselves in the physical stuff, but their only worry is if Beths send the real pace men at them around the outside. So it'll be interesting to see how that pans out. But Pocklington at the moment have put five in the line out, and they've kept Daniel Adamola out, but you can expect him to potentially carry this big one up, a real talisman for the side. But, well, actually first it's going to be Bickley Parton who does it, and then there is Adamola. Good carry from him, and the cheer goes up from the Pocklington fans with us. But Pocklington have created some really good room on the outside here, and this is a brilliant run from Harry Matthews. He needs support to get there fast. There was an attempt. I think he might have even been penalised for a squeeze ball. Good start for Pocklington.
Oh, absolutely. I remember speaking to some coaches last week at Rosslyn Park when Pocklington were brought into Group A at the last second, and they were all worried about the strength that they were going to have. He mentioned lack of pace perhaps in the back line, but the outside centre there certainly put in pay to that in the early phases. A couple of minutes in and they'll get confidence from that.
Yeah, no slouch, was he? Beths Grammar School with the line out over on the far side. Decent jump from Nathan Grant. Back line's waiting for the referee to call the line out over, and now they can proceed and try and put pressure on Beths as they come out from their 22. Good decision from Sam Dyson to hold on to that. He could have gone for a release to try and keep it alive, but it would have put his teammate in all sorts of pressure. But Pocklington just going over the ball, hands over the ball, signal from the referee, and Beths will have a chance to pump this down to the near touchline and have a line out. Beths, who overcame Dorothy Stringer in the semi-final, that's a school, it wasn't just a lady called Dorothy Stringer. Quarter-finals, they beat King Henry the VII Coventry, 22 points to 5. Also dispatched Colchester, 19 points to 7. Dover Grammar School, 55-33. Those just some of the schools they've seen off on their way. Made it to the under-15 Vars quarter-final in 2011. That's their pedigree in the big competitions. Beths did have a couple of showings in the emerging schools tournament several years ago. This is definitely their best achievement in terms of schoolboy rugby, and what a great opportunity it is to give these players the chance to play at an arena such as Six Ways, the home of Worcester Warriors. Penalty comes to Pocklington as Beths hold on in the tackle.
A lot of the time in the occasions in schoolboy rugby, it's the team that settles first will go on to be successful, as I think they're going to have a missed touch with the kick there. Both of them have given away a lot of penalties. We've had five penalties in 3 minutes.
Yeah, that could prove to hurt either side, but it's Pocklington now who have taken advantage in the end, although they missed the touch finder. The clearing of the lines from Beths wasn't too accurate either, and it's going to be another chance for Bickley Parton to do the carrying duty. And are we going to have the game's first try?
Time off.
No. Oh, referee, I think he's going to consult his touch judge.
Any reason I can't award the try?
I'm happy.
Happy? Yep, cool.
Thank you.
try's gone down. And it is for Adamola.
Well, I think we were all lamenting them there for not going for the sticks. 10 metres out, the opportunity to get points on the board. They had a great amount of faith that they could get over the whitewash, and they did. A brilliant, big, strong finish by the number 8. And what a start inside 5 minutes here.
Beths Grammar School with a chance to add the extras, but that one just goes wide. But a decent start from them. First one's onto the scoreboard then, with the try through Adamola. Pocklington with the restart. Dyson. Oh, it was just knocked forward by Joseph Leander. Pocklington now looking to break. This is really nice stuff. Kick downfield ended up straight into the hands of Beth Spike Weeks. A bit of a juggle. We've seen a couple of those from Nathan Grant. Adamola shrugs off that first tackle, gets a good leg drive and makes a few more metres. Then they get it away to Ted Burrows, plays a bit of rugby at Blackheath. Trying to really work around the breakdown. Speaking to Niall Temple before the game, he said it's going to be an up the jumper strategy, as they then choose to try and put a bit more width on it. And it was Liam Sheath, but now breaking away, it's James Powell. Oh, Powell still going. He's not held in the tackle either, despite what Ben Maycock's trying to do. Then a solid arrival from Grant again. He's done some really big carrying for Beth so far. They might have created some room out here. They've got a man on the outside. The tacklers are there from Pocklington, but the ball gets away to Weeks. If he could have just got the little offload back inside, then they might have had an opportunity, but it is still there for Beths Grammar School. Are they going to get a second try here in quick succession after the first? They're held up and driven back on the line while it's in the hands of Lucas Nathan. Adamola's there, looks to go from close range again, and he does. When he's in range to sniff the trial, and he certainly knows how to finish. Plays rugby for Kent County, and Adamola gets Beths Grammar School second try.
Well, that's two tries for the big ball carrier number 8, and he's gone through some work trying to clear the lines as well. When, as you said, they were keeping it at the jumper, but what about the work from the outside centre? James Powell, two clean breaks from him to get them into the opposition 22. All of the good work in attack so far has come from him.
Similar position for the conversion. Decent effort first time, just went past the uprights. Has it helped as a bit of a sighter? Oh, maybe overcompensating back the other way, Dan Mitchell.
Well, that was a great offload out the back door just to put the 15 in there. Spike Weeks, he arrived late, he was looking to hit it at pace. Credit to Pocklington for not allowing him to get the ball down there. They just need to find a way to get their hands on the ball, but it's relentless stuff from Beths. 2-3 attempts at getting over the line there. The strength of the East Yorkshire side, but they bring it left here. Keep your eye out for the number 8, the captain. Goes over for his second try. Low, powerful leg drive. Makes it 10-0.
Yeah, excellent technical finishing from the skipper. Pocklington, apart from a couple of little forays a moment ago before they then ended up back down defending on their own line, haven't had too much possession to speak of. That's been the key so far. At Beths Grammar School have just looked so strong. They're still getting some go forward on this. The referee will tell them to use it if it stops, but no need. They'll have the put into the scrum. Pocklington really aware they're in a physical battle this morning.
Well, we talked about Pocklington's physicality, but it's been Beths who have come here with a game plan. In the first 10 minutes here, they've executed it incredibly well. They don't want to put boot to ball. They want to keep it narrow up to the halfway line. And then try and get it in the hands of the Speeds merchants. So far, so good. Two scores to the good.
Fellas, stability just wants that one reset. In, please. Eight, just make sure you're bound in for me, please. Thank you. Crouch! Bind! In you go.
Messages set. On social media to at Schools Cup. Mrs. Steele, best of luck under 15 rugby from Pop School in the Schools Cup. Class 1 wire ready to cheer you on. Hashtag bleed blue. Well, they're certainly putting the pressure on there. That's really solid work from Cameron Adams in the player pathway at Yorkshire Carnegie. But it's that man again, Adamola. And then Nathan Grant, so used to seeing those two combining. Service away from Ty Sirst. Then they want to put a bit of pressure on Pocklington from the back. But running forward, oh, this is nice from William Dare. Needs the support to arrive, but where Beths Grammar School tried to force the turnover, they didn't release the tackler. So decent play from Pocklington there and William Dare.
Well, the first time we've seen any incisive running here. Here comes Dare, steps in, but doesn't really have any options. But they've managed to get the penalty and a little bit of territory here.
From Nichols, the man who was fingered by the referee as not releasing the tackle. Pocklington line out. Big call for Sheese. And he gets that one in. Twin brother Niall, who's on the bench. And it's wrestled away. They fancy trying to take them on with the back row of Cameron Adams. And then it's to his other back row colleague, Afonso Spencer. Then on to Michael Smith, the captain. And then another big carry from Edward Hastell. They're determined now to prove to Beths Grammar School that they can mix it up front as well. Penalty to Pocklington. This is the position of the field that, will allow them to kick to the corner if they back themselves, which they do. No messing around.
Well, what I enjoyed about that were the support lines from the forwards. They looked like they were running out of space, but then a big second row comes in on the offload and gets over the gain line again. This is much better from Pocklington, finally finding some go forward. And will they have the opportunity to do so again? Maybe the back row broke from the breakdown a little bit quicker than they'd have liked. But this is a great position.
They come round the corner from the line out. Nice move. They were all aware of what was coming next. John Wright arrived. He was just driven back.
Ball's available. Back foot, please, Black. Thank you.
Now, Pocklington, are they looking to try and get a bit of width on it? Edward James.
Come back to that advantage penalty.
Taking three of the Beths Grammar School players to stop him, but there is an advantage being played to Pocklington. They've got three compared to one out on the left if they could have spotted the opportunity as Matthews carries on. Now they play to the left. John Wright. Big front row man is pushing towards that line, but He's going to have a job to try and get it to the deck. So I think the referee recognises that and says we'll go back for the penalty.
Well, big forwards just love getting their hands on the ball. We've seen two carries there from John Wright. We were expecting the big, strong, physical stuff from Pocklington as they want to go quickly here.
Wait. Back 10, fellas, please.
The referee just slows them down. This is what they need to do. Drag in some of the defenders from Beths.
Well, they've decided to just take the tap and go, and it's a long throw over the top from Henry Hughes. They've recognised where the men are in that corner, and have they got the room to get there? They have. It's Ben Maycock who touches down.
Well, it was an excellent finish in the end. They wanted to put width on it, but perhaps weren't as deep as they needed to be. Maycock, of course, only came in at the last minute, and he has had a real impact on the final. Have a look at this pickup here. As the ball goes to ground, difficult one, does well to gather it low, pins his ears back, heads for the corner. It was a good attempt at the cover tackle. But Pocklington back in this, just what they needed. 15 minutes in and three scores. This is some final.
Yes, it certainly is. Voice of Dave Rogers. My name's Nick Heath. We hope you're enjoying our coverage of the live stream. Attempt from wide out on the left. Harry Matthews begins his routine and his run-up. Strikes it right-footed. It's not quite going to have the legs. Direction wasn't too bad, but two tries to one. Beths Grammar School still with the lead, but Pocklington will take heart from that.
Well, they wanted to go quickly from the penalty. The referee dragged them back. Look how many forwards are narrow there, so they decided to put some width on it, get it in the hands of the backs. The pass wasn't as clean from Sam Dyson as he'd have liked, but it was an excellent pickup from the left winger. Ben Maycock gets on the scoreboard, and Pocklington half the deficit.
Hashtag NatWest Schools Cup, if you would like to get your messages across for us on the live stream. Plenty of you backing blue. Got a bit of work to do. That is an exceptional turnover from Adamola. Needs his teammates to help continue giving him the go forward, but they're then happy to send it out and release the backs. Joseph Leander with that carry. Now they come with Dan Mitchell. And now they find it out to the wing and Lucas Nathan, and then on the wraparound is Weeks. Feeds it quickly back in field. Powell again. Good interplay from Beths. Adamola still going forwards, taking a big hit from John Wright, who eventually brings the man down. They're going to have to use some of their bigger men to bring down Adamola.
Knock on, scrum black ball.
I'm really impressed with Spike Weeks, the Beths fullback. He's got a really good habit of joining the line late, trying to hit the ball at pace. That's a couple of times there. He's just appeared on the overlap on the left-hand side. And I think as Pocklington maybe tire later in the game, he might find himself a little bit of space there. Good fullback play.
When I say crouch, okay? Thank you. Crouch. Bind. Set.
That's Grammar School opt to come out to the right. Oh, and it's a huge big sell on the dummy. And then the support line. Is the referee happy with the last pass? He is. Was it Harry Matthew? Oh, sorry, was it James Powell in there?
Well, that's the try that his hard work has deserved so far, but brilliant work from Ted Burrows at 10. Very often in these matches where we bring schoolboy competition onto these 4G pitches, it's a chance for the 10s to really express themselves. Have a look at this. Dummy there, step off the right foot, past one defender, past the fullback as well. Takes seven on, who nearly gets in to intercept it, but it was a good support line from James Powell. He's done a lot of work, particularly in the opening phases, to get Beths on top.
Maybe next one.
But held a good line there and got the try that his industries deserved. And Beths, the perfect way to respond with the kick to come.
It's a slightly more straightforward effort for Dan Mitchell.
Yes.
Lovely from Mitchell. And the first successful conversion of the day gets over. And Beth's lead by 17 points to 5.
Let's take another look at this then. Oh, I'm pretty sure he'll enjoy watching that back. Three tackles he skipped through. Just timed the pass to perfection. Drew the fullback. And it was a pretty simple finish in the end for James Powell. 17-5.
Big, big run from Joseph Leander.
Release block! Thank you.
Plenty of call from down below us from the coaches to encourage Pocklington to go wide. They go route one to begin with, Adamola. Well, he was in a good position, but I think the referee has more of an issue with Ted Burrows not rolling away.
Well, a bit of a get out of jail there for Pocklington. Because as you can see, the tackle was made. More work from the eight there, from the captain. He had hands on it. But the body in the way, the referee in the right place, and another great chance here for Pocklington.
Gone for a simple catch and drive here. Now they break. Adams initially. Now it's away from Harry Jones through Sanguin. Running back against the grain. Oh, it's brilliant footwork from Harry Matthews. He's got his team to within 2 metres of the line here.
Tackle, release block.
Referee says to play on. Solid defence from Beths holding up the man over the line, but well, I wondered for a moment where Harry Matthews was going. But he did just keep evading the tackle, stepping off that left foot.
Well, he looked to be getting himself in a lot of trouble, didn't he? But he's taken 6 players out there. Couldn't quite finish it, but that'll give him a lot of confidence. First time he's really had the opportunity to express himself. And Pocklington's deep in the 22.
Fellas, just take one step back.
Another big chance.
Thank you.
Okay. Interestingly, they've got no one on the blind side here.
Pocklington, get that one in. Is there going to be a break down the blind side? Yes, there is, and he might fancy his battle to get over, and the big cheer goes up. Pocklington certainly here in number to watch Henry Hughes get over. He plays a bit of rugby league, and that was route one stuff from the number 8.
Well, I had my suspicions if it was going that way. They had a lot of space on the right-hand side. I was wondering which way is the scrum going to wheel. It actually wheels left, but away goes the 8.
Thank you.
A little bit high on the tackle there from the winger. He might be disappointed with that, but you know what it's like with number 8s breaking from the scrum. They have got one thing in mind, and that's get forward. He's got towards the try line there, dotted it down, and once again, Pocklington's have managed to close the gap.
Come on, keep working on it.
Really important couple of minutes for them now to see how they can withstand the ominous, or the obvious, should I say, Beth's onslaught.
Matthews then, the one with the run that set up the try-scoring position, arguably. Not bad at all. Oh, it's just faded past. But great to see you keeping in touch with us on hashtag Natwest Schools Cup. Enjoying watching the live coverage.
Yes, a very warm welcome to you all. Let's have another look at this try then. Plenty of space there. The captain, Adamola, tried to get across, but the one missed tackle made it difficult for him. Got there in the end, but it was too little too late. And a good finish in space by Henry Hughes.
Good to see a picture of those of you watching on the big screen in the classroom at Pocklington Prep. As Beths Grammar School get us restarted. Got a decent final here as Pocklington break again. Searing up towards the 22. Is anyone going to stop him? What a run from the captain. And then a pick and go from Bickley Parton. Oh, he's just lost it on the floor. What a run from Michael Smith.
Well, what did we say before? The big forwards just love getting their hands on the ball. Very few things in rugby make me happier than a galloping second row going into space. Let's take a look at this. Good awareness.
A galloping prop probably marginally coming ahead.
Not sure you can call that galloping. But take a look at this. Knows he's got a couple of men to beat. Desperate for someone supporting. But they're back in the 22 despite the knock-on. This is the place on the pitch where they want to be. Good fight back from Pocklington.
A word for Ishmael Mansaray, who was the man who eventually got back and made the tackle after a few of his teammates perhaps stood up a little high. He got in and got those legs away.
Crouch. Bind. Set.
Looking. Beth's under a bit of pressure inside their 22, and well, they opted to clear the lines. It wasn't conventional. Oh, and then there's a knock on, so this will be an advantage for Pocklington now. And they get it into the hands of Hasdell, who is a decent ball carrier, but he opts to set up the platform. And we might see a bit more of the backs here if Louis Sanguin can fire it out for, well, it wasn't going to be Matthews. In fact, it's been taken in by Nathan. Nathan clears it out of the 22, but all he's done there is find the clutches of Ben Maycock, and Maycock looks to the outside, and are we going to see a try for Sam Dyson? Dyson is in for Pocklington, and this final is bubbling away beautifully. Three tries apiece, and Pocklington in for another.
Well, it's absolutely come alive. As soon as they put boot to ball, it was absolute carnage. There was the chip to the corner. It was well gathered by the man on the left-hand side. Let's take a look at this. But he looked to kick for touch. It was a long clearance. He was asking a lot of his right boot. There was a lovely step inside there by Maycock, who scored the first try. Puts Dyson in. A good finish for him. Beats the flanker, beats the hooker, and brings Pocklington to within 2 points after 26 minutes here.
What a first half that we are getting to enjoy here to kick off our school's finals. We have the under-15 bowl final that you're watching, the under-15 plate final to come, and then similar in the under-18s competition this afternoon. Matthews kicking is certainly being tested over the course of where these tries are going down, but they'll be happy enough with the third score and to be within two. But this was the problem clearance really that opened it up for Pocklington.
Well, he didn't really have an option. At this age group, of course, we do put a lot of pressure on the kickers. I mean, we just saw it with the place kick there. It's a long way for a teenage boot. But let's not concentrate on that. Let's concentrate on the try, the good work there by Maycock, putting the centre into space, and his awareness of where the try line was and what he had to do to bring his team back into this.
Restart from Mitchell. Really, really well done. Nathan Grant competing brilliantly, and then it's Joseph Leander. And it's loose, but there was a hand on the ball.
No advantage coming. Scrum.
Referee has gone for the knock on there. Pocklington perhaps a little lucky because there was a man on the ball playing it with his hand, and that could have been a penalty.
Well, there were cheers from the crowd there because they thought the turnover was coming. It's amazing when you sat down there cheering on your team how you temporarily forget the rules from time to time.
It's passionate support down there, isn't it?
Flankers eight. Crouch. Bind. Set.
Ready, ready, ready!
Beth's Grammar School coming up to the 22. It's another good run from Ted Burrows. We saw him doing that earlier when he was able to put Powell in for the try, and they're keeping it alive at the minute. And Tice Hurst, the flanker then, Adamola, goes backwards to begin with, needs to try and recycle that ball for his teammates, which he does. Then it's Ticehurst Lawrence that time. It comes back to Lucas Powell. Sorry, James Powell. Apologies. Well, there's a penalty being given here. Coaches down below are encouraging the team to make sure they ask our referee, Andy Wigley,
shot called.
About how much longer he's got left, and I think the referee's told him that if they kick it out, that will be the end. So their option is to take 3 points.
And a sensible option too. It's a similar position to the penalty they ignored before they got the first try. And I think in their exuberance, they were going to go for the corner again, but the opportunity to give themselves a five-point lead going into half-time, especially in a match of this magnitude with the opposition on the crest of a wave, as it were, I think this is a sensible decision.
You know, difficult to split the sides at the minute. Once they have the ball, each of them looking good. But this, a chance for another 3 points for the boot of Dan Mitchell. Beautifully struck from Mitchell. No problem at all. So it will be a 5 point advantage at the break for Beths Grammar School. 3 tries for them in that first half. 2 from Adamola, 1 from Powell, 3 from Pocklington, Maycock, Hughes and Dyson on the board. And 5 points from Dan Mitchell gives us a half-time score of Beths Grammar School 20, Pocklington School 15.
Well, what a final so far. Brilliant start by Beths, those 2 scores from the captain. But what I have been particularly impressed with is the character of Pocklington's. It would have been quite easy for them to drop their heads, being beaten at their own game. We expected them to be a big physical forward pack, but they were taken apart in the early stages, but then they mounted the fight back, and they'll take a lot of heart from that. They trail by 5 here, but this final is very much alive.
Well, we mentioned earlier how Beths Grammar School came through the competition. Pocklington beat King's Priory in the semi-final, 24 points to nil. Clevedon, 18 points to 3 in the quarters. They saw off Birkdale, Millthorpe, Richmond, Wolferton and Hull Collegiate in various games, or the game against Hull Collegiate was the defeat, sorry, where it got them into this bowl competition. This very much their best ever performance, but, well, where we expected the teams to be fairly equally matched. Well, they certainly have been, as you can see, just 5 points between them. It was nearly 2 if it wasn't for that Dan Mitchell penalty right on the stroke of half-time. Well, welcome back to our continued coverage of finals day here at Six Ways in the NatWest Schools Cup. This, the under 15 bowl final. My name's Nick Heath, alongside me, Dave Rogers. And Dave, we've witnessed an action-packed first half there with Beths Grammar School just shading it at the break.
Well, six tries, only the kicks separating the teams. That's a deep start as well. Is it going to get the bounce? Has that caught a toe on the way through?
I think the referee is happy enough to bring it back to the 22. He's not put an inquest in there, but yeah, certainly looked for a moment like it might have.
There were a few nervous Beths moments there. But not the start that Pocklington's would have wanted. Because it's important for them to have a steady start with this set. They conceded two early scores, Beths.
Pocklington with the break up to the 10-metre line. I think we're just checking that our co-commentary microphone is working fully so that we can hear from Dave Rogers. And in the meantime, Louis Sanguin, big long kick into the corner, wants to put some pressure on Beths. Oh, and now it's loose and it's into the dead ball area. And they've conceded a fair amount of territory there under pressure. And it's left Pocklington with a 5-metre attacking scrum. You can just see here, Beths Lucas Nathan. Well, it was a loose pass, and then he decided under pressure to put the ball down. I think his skipper, Adamola, might have fancied the chance to try and run that out instead of giving this platform to Pocklington. But, Dave, can we hear you now?
I hope so. Well, it's obviously something they talked about at half-time. Pocklington's playing in the right areas, hence the long kick-off, and Beths have made life easy for them here.
Well, it's another pick-and-go, and we saw that earlier. Are they over? Referee says they are. It's another try for Henry Hughes, and Pocklington are enjoying these platforms from the scrum because it's currently only got one outcome.
Well, two pick-and-goes from the number eight and two scores. Let's take a look at this here. He mentioned that he plays some rugby league, and you can see, look how strong he is running upright. Even with that much height, running straight into 10, manages to take him over the line with him. Talked about a great start to the second half. Doesn't get much better than that, and we're all square.
It's exactly what Pocklington needed. They level on the scores. This to take the lead for the first time. Meat and drink to a kicker such as Harry Matthews. And indeed, Pocklington now shade it on the scoreboard by 20 points to 22 now.
Well, brilliant stuff. I think Beths will have learned their lesson there. As you mentioned, the captain might have fancied getting from the in-goal area. They can't give Pocklington's anything. Those big forwards finally delivering on what we expected them to after what can be described as a shaky start, I suppose. But with ball in hand and possession, they found ways to get into the 22 and get scores. But, well, a chance straight away for Beths to come back.
Well, indeed. And not only was it a knock-on, but the man who picked the ball up was in front of him, so it becomes an offside penalty. So a real chance for Beths to bite back. Harry Matthews, incidentally, on that last conversion, will have been pleased, finally, that his teammates didn't score out wide.
Thanks, mate.
Opportunity to get his first 2 points from the boot, which he took. Now, line out time.
Yeah, those kicks from out wide. He had a very methodical approach to things. But under the sticks, nope, just come up and boot it.
Interesting to see that it's Lawrence Ticehurst, the scrum half, who takes on the hooking duties. The underarm throw, we saw plenty of that at the Roslyn Park Sevens, but they're getting a real trundle on this, our Beths Grammar School. Pocklington with little answer to it. They're trying to put more men into that maul, and it does just temporarily stop, but Adamola at the back crashes down, and my goodness me, what an efficient catch and drive that was from Beths Grammar School. A real warning sign to Pocklington that they can kill them from that form of set piece. And Adamola with his hat-trick.
Yeah, what a day this is for the captain. But let's take a look at this again. They've applied it in their own territory as a way of getting out of keeping it narrow, but that just marched forward. Brilliant organisation from Beths. Their coaches will be absolutely delighted with the way that they've executed the game plan. But look at the numbers in there. Pocklington, people just arriving as it got closer to the line, but not able to make any difference. As soon as it's moving forward, they knew exactly where the ball was. Looked to stutter for a second, but down goes eight there. That's as easy a try as he'll score all season. And a great display from him. A hat-trick and still plenty of time to go.
Conversion just fading to the left. So we're back to where we were just before that break at half-time, with Beths marginally with their noses in front. 25 points to 22, they have the lead, but you sense there is enough time in this game for the lead to change hands several times. Such has been the score and reply nature of this game. Solid run, and then Adamola on the shoulder, and he's a big man, and he's now going with open water in front of him. Adamola, is he going to go the whole way? He's being chased. He's put an arm in the air. Goodness me, that was an early celebration with someone on his tails, wasn't it? Adamola with try number four. And crucially, Beths Grammar School getting another score before Pocklington had the opportunity to reply, but that one straight from the restart and straight from the top draw.
Well, that was an early celebration, but it was an excellent offload there, as all good back rowers do. Offered himself at the offload, picked it up well inside his own half there. He's gone 20 metres already, and he's only just up over the halfway line.
Thank you.
It was a valiant chase there from Sanguin, but look at that celebration, 15 metres out. There'd have been egg on his face if he'd not managed to score there, but big man, lots of pace, very difficult to bring down. Four tries, what a performance from your captain.
It was a semi-swan dive to finish from Adamola, and this is Dan Mitchell to add the extras. No problem from Mitchell. 10 points now, the gap. Pocklington have shown that they can come back from a 10-point deficit previously, but this was quite some score.
Well, you called it a swan dive. I'm not sure it was as graceful as that. His try just a couple of minutes prior, we called it the easiest that he'd score all season. This was probably the most difficult. Didn't have to beat a lot of tackles, but had to have great awareness of his surroundings, even when he put his arm up as the attempted tap tackle was coming in. All of 75 metres, fantastic score.
I don't know whether I love that or I hate it, Dave. It's one of those.
He's so tough.
Certainly enjoyed it anyway. Beths Grammar School coming forward again. They'll have real confidence as a team with Thank what you. The captain has done for them. Sheese, then on to Adamola, and then they come away through Nichols, and now they've got room with Lucas Nathan on that far side, one of those players playing up a year. They've got couple of under-14s in the lineup. Dan Cunningham on the bench is another one for Beths Grammar School. A few more in the Pocklington lineup. So changes being made for Beths Grammar School. Number 99, Jerry Adegoke, is onto the field, and there is a lovely little story about Beths Grammar School sending the shirts away to be printed, and they said to the replacements, "Well, you're on the bench, you can have any number you like. What would you like?" Adegoke said, I'll have number 99. Then they were called by the RFU, said, "You do realise you need to be numbers 1 to 22. The printers had already done their job, and he's on as number 99. And why not?"
Absolutely, why not? Big day, big number. Hopefully he'll make a big impact.
Absolutely.
Crouch. Bind. Set.
Good platform. Good opportunity for Beths again. And it's a solid tackle. Needed to be on Dan Mitchell because they were building up another head of steam. And Adamola goes around the corner at the breakdown. Tyce Hurst feeds Nathan Grant, but
you help bring him to ground, you assist,
no
tackle,
release on the tackled player from Pocklington, excuse me.
Well, an important couple of minutes here for Pocklington's, because another score and surely it's game over. They've shown that they can come back from 10 points already, but then they managed to get themselves some territory. They're being pinned back here. Beths, well, with the tight game plan they've had, they'll be looking to suffocate the life out of this final now.
Blue on the line, please, fellas. Blue on the line. Lads, you're on the line.
So good to see the introduction of Harry Cowan now for Pocklington. For Alfonso Spencer. Now we've got the familiar look of a Beths Grammar School maul, but Pocklington beginning to defend that really well. Then Adamola goes himself. He's in search of try number five. But Tysas now gets it away. Burrows stepping field with that really physical outside centre and James Powell. Now the ball is hacked through from the new man, Cowan. But they will have to go again through Beths. Adamola is brought to the ground, looking all the while he was to his outside. There's an advantage being played and trying to run up that touchline. Finn Nichols just run out of turf.
Well, the danger there from the driving maul again, but it was big John Wright, number three for Pocklington. He was holding that one up pretty much on his own, marching it towards the touchline. Gargantuan effort there from the prop forward.
10 points between the sides.
Crouch. Bind. Set.
Tyce Hurst.
Hold your push, blue.
Gets it away from the back of the scrum. We're not going to see Adamola doing an appeal from the back this time, and then building up a real head of steam into the tackle was Mitchell. Not afraid of the physical stuff. Lucas Nathan. Penalty Beths. And Pocklington are just going to be had a word with here by the referee.
Yeah, let's take a look at this here. Saw some feet go up in the air from the tackle.
Okay, he's lifted him. Just needs to be very careful.
Just the pick and go. Yeah, and he was lifted there. His legs did go up. Is the referee happy that a talking to will suffice? It's Cameron Adams there. Perhaps doesn't know his own strength.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, what's going to be the option for Beths here? Are they going to opt for the scrum? Do they fancy a tap and go? Tyce Hurst just taps and they will go. And he gives it to Powell again, and now they're trying to find some width. Oh, and it was knocked on. Didn't quite work out for Adegoke.
Well, let off there for Pocklington's. That was Adegoke. That would have been his first touch as well. What an impact to have on the final. Again, Beths here, they had plenty of numbers. The pass was there. Maybe got a bit excited about the prospect of scoring a try in the cup final.
It's the big number on the back. He's put all that pressure on himself, hasn't he?
Okay, back row, bound in, please. Yep, crouch. Bind.
Oscar Hawksworth is on as well for Pocklington, just at the top of your picture. Now they break from the back, and we've certainly seen plenty of Henry Hughes, double try scorer for Pocklington. They need to get themselves out of this area of the field and put the pressure on Beths. They get a penalty. This will give them a chance to perhaps take it up the touchline, as we see Pocklington get it into the hands of Harry Matthews to send a kick upfield. Colby Fofi, who's also onto the field for Pocklington. 21 with the scrum cap just to the right. Pocklington needs secure ball here. Fofi's the man who jumps. Easiest one to lift because he's certainly one of the lighter.
Eight back foot.
It's a really good drive by Pocklington there. Making a statement here to Beths that when they get themselves organised, they can go too. But they're going to have to get this out unless they're planning to score a try from 60 yards out on a rolling maul. They've got a penalty advantage now. Coaches are encouraging the players to use it.
And also encouraging James Powell to get onside as well, because he was just admiring the Pocklington forward work.
Oh, it's just been knocked on by Pocklington there, but they had the penalty advantage. Coming in at the side of the maul, and Matthews will take it up the touchline, and if they can get even closer, well, it might be the maul. Oh, my goodness me, he's got that absolutely inch perfect. They're going to have every metre up to that 5 metre channel to go, and this will be a worrying moment for Beths as they work out how to defend the driving maul from Pocklington.
Well, what a kick that is.
Got to win the ball first, of course.
As you mentioned, inch perfect kick there, and the forward pack will be riding high following that. And I would not bet against exactly the same thing happening from the line out here.
Here we go then. Who's it going to be? It is Fofi again, and last time he was able to get down and direct his forwards around him. At the minute, it's not become the maul that they might have wanted, and then it's been knocked on. Is there going to be turnover ball here for Beths? They've got the advantage, but it's been knocked on by Adamola. But crucially for Pocklington, they just couldn't get the maul to form. And this has ended up being a let-off for Beths.
Well, at this age, of course, the line-outs are uncontested, so Beths had the chance to really set themselves and get the counter-drive going before Pocklington's could form. Smart play from Beths.
William Watts coming onto the field, as is Alfie Hall. Harry Jones being replaced.
Thank you.
We're seeing Ben Maycock perhaps stepping in to play scrum half.
Okay, lads, we sorted. Let's go then.
No, sorry, it is William Watts.
Yeah. Right, crouch.
And interestingly, they've got Henry Hughes, the big number eight, defending in the centres here.
Yes, indeed. Wary perhaps of that break from Adamola, but they opt instead to keep it going down the back line. Ted Burrows the one happy to make that initial carry, but as Pocklington struggle to defend, Adamola picks it up and sets up the platform. Ty Searst. Harry McGurk with a really good break here. McGurk took on the last line of defence, but William Dare did just enough. But there is a penalty here. And is the referee going to have to make a decision here? Because you don't want a Schools Cup final ruined with a yellow card, but at some point, Pocklington have got to be wary of how much they're killing the ball when Beths have the advantage.
Well, they just can't handle them when they break, can they? They had the opportunity there. Such great work from the forward pack to get them in that position. But Beths, again through the captain. I mean, he scored four tries, but his work to relieve the pressure. Take a look at this here. Well, we talked about second rows going through gaps, but props as well. Harry McGuirk puts the hammer down. They love running at backs too. Gets through the fullback's tackle, sets it up. But as you say, Pocklington killing the ball again. Not really having any option other than to do so, but that's when the referee has to step in.
Ty Searst. Goes with the option at the front, and it's straight down, and then it's into Nathan Grant, who's not done with his carrying duties for the day yet, and then Tom Seeley with the carry. Ty Searst gets it away. Man running around the corner was Liam Sheese, one of the two sets of twins we have. in this Beths Grammar School side. Tysurst, oh, it's just gone out of the back, but Grant will happily tidy it up. He did have Adegoke looking forward on the outside, but he couldn't free his arms to get it away, so takes it in the physical stuff. And then Ademola, who's brought down by a combination of two of the Pocklington defenders, but then they go for a bit of quick hands, and they might be creating some room out on the left here. Oh, perhaps it needed to go. Ismail Mansaray was fancying it. He then picks and goes himself, says, if I'm not going to get it from the pass, I'll take it from the breakdown. But now, is it coming back on the Pocklington side? No. The competition for the ball on the floor has seen Beths with it. And Pocklington have got themselves a penalty as Beths go off their feet to try and secure the ball. And they tap and go quickly. He's got to make sure that he doesn't run away from his support here, but he's running away from the tacklers. And Harry Matthews is going upfield. Does he believe he can go there all himself? Well, the intervention from Beths as Spike Weeks came across was just enough. Let's have another look.
Well, what a break and great awareness as well. All the crowds here at Six Ways are beneath us, and I can almost feel our commentary position shaking.
Thank you, mate.
I'm not entirely sure how that ball has ended up going out of play, but it's gone forward. Well, well, well. I don't want to say chance gone begging, because he'd sort of fabricated it himself. There he goes. He's gone quickly. He was aware that Beth's defence would be flat-footed. The chase was on there. It was Nathan Grant. Let's take a look here. He's got the ball in his right hand. Cross comes 15. Oh, he's actually passed him as well.
He's just lost it out the right, and there perhaps is an argument for keeping the ball in both hands.
Well, we'll put that one down to rotten luck, but just under 10 minutes to go here, according to our clock. Is there life in Pocklington yet?
Okay. If that try had gone down, well, it certainly would have tightened things up for the run into the final whistle.
Come off a bit, come off a bit there. Time's cool. Scrum.
And coming to you live on the NatWest Schools Cup live stream from Six Ways, the home of Worcester Warriors. It's Beths Grammar School 32, Pocklington School 22. 10 points between the sides as the kick comes downfield from Beths, and it'll be fielded at the back by William Dare, who gets around the first tackle of Mansaray. Pocklington coming and twisting through the tackles with Cowan, the replacement, who's looked good since he's come on. And now the man who made the break a moment ago, he's still going. He's a real threat, Matthews. But then the ball comes squirting out the side. Referee's not happy with it, and Matthews is on the floor, perhaps needing a bit of attention.
Well, maybe just a breather, because he's had a lung-busting couple of minutes. Keeps hold of it well there. Remember, it was his run against the grain that set up the opening try. And he's really working hard to try and be the catalyst.
He might have taken a knee from Ademola as he came into the breakdown.
And let's just tidy up, make sure players are arriving on their feet.
Andy Wigley just wants a word with Ademola.
Yeah, thank you.
I think credit to the referee. He's refereed the big moments well here.
In fact, that's going to be the last contribution we see from Harry Matthews. It's been a bright spark for Pocklington, eaten up the yards on the few breaks that he's had. But now Pocklington go, and they're looking to try and get straight into the corner. Ball's away from Watts. Then it's into the midst of Edward Hasdell. It's still in the air more than it's to ground. They desperately want it to ground, because otherwise Beths will force the turnover here. They get it there. Fofi guards it. Duggleby helps it get away. Then it's with Adams. And now, oh, we're going to see our first yellow card of the game. And I think it's going to Ted Burrows. Goodness me. After all of the infringing that Pocklington did on their own line, I'm relatively surprised to see Beths as the first one with a man in the bin. But referee decided it was a crucial period where Pocklington had the advantage, and they go again with Harry Cowan. Breaking to the right, This is Sanguin. And then Adams up to the 5 metre line once more.
Fine. Good work. Well done, eight.
It's been well, I thought it was turned over from Beths, but the referee on the spot.
Tackle! Release block! Release!
Tells Beths to release the player, but the ball's gone to ground as well. We'll have another penalty for Pocklington.
Well, they want to give us a grandstand finish, don't they? I think going back to the yellow card, Pocklington had three men who could have gone in unopposed on the right-hand side. I think the referee deciding enough's enough.
Thought for a minute Sanguin was looking at going into the corner, but that ball back in field was just floated too much, and an invitation for Nathaniel Ticehurst, who plucks it out of the air, and they will clear downfield and ask Pocklington to come forward again, which they do. And have they got some room down the left? The cheers go up. First tackle's missed. Second tackle was good, but they weren't going to stop Sam Dyson. And Dyson, having switched into that inside centre for the game to make room for Maycock after Ben McNamara was out, certainly one of the star players in the side. Well, Dyson has proved to be pretty handy himself. He gets Pocklington's try, which brings them back to within 5 points. Dave Rogers.
Well, game on again. Pocklington, well, they just won't lie down, will they? It was a fantastic reception from the kickoff. Let's take a look at this here. Perhaps Beths might think there was an infringement there and a block, but he went round the winger like he wasn't there. Took another player like he wasn't. Well, just brilliant stuff. He's gone past two tackles, through the final one, and Pocklington's with the kick to come.
Thank you.
Right back in this.
Yeah, six and a half.
Well, Dyson to convert his own kick. Matthews has been largely taking the lion's share of kicks so far. Dyson with his second try of the game. And it's a tricky conversion effort from wide out on the left.
Thank you, mate. 15 black.
6.5 minutes to go, says our referee.
6 minutes.
5 points in it now. Beths Grammar School.
He'll come on with about one or two.
Time for them, if they need to kick on and make sure of this lead. Pocklington, who have now come back within striking distance to win it. Beths, of course, let's not forget, who are down to 14 with that yellow card.
Well, since that long-range Adamola try, Beths have lost their focus somewhat. Both teams have failed to capitalise on some really good possession in the opponent's 22.
Sanguin combining nicely with Adams, and it's as if Pocklington have just started to believe that actually sending these rangy runners through the gaps against Beths, that they're going to get a bit more profit from it. Beths are not making the first up tackles as perhaps you might expect a physical side like them to do. Now then, that touch finder has not found touch on that left side, so it's well kept in field. It was a good take from Martin Ryan on that left side. Beths coming forward again. Ticehurst. Adamola. And, well, we have a player down on the far side, and it's James Powell. It's been a big contributor for Beths so far, but the referee has just said we're going to need a little moment to pause. I didn't see what happened on first viewing. Certainly we hope that James Powell is okay.
Well, we can see some of the leaders on the field there just trying to bring their players in and go through some final plans here. I think the break-in play might do Beths a favour and just allow them to compose themselves and see if they can maintain the discipline to see this one out. As for Pocklington, well, they're right back in this, and they, I think for them, they just need to throw everything at it because they don't want to leave this pitch with any regrets. They've trailed for the vast majority of this final, but even when they were two scores down and off the back of the captain Adamola running in a 70-metre try, they still found a way to stay in this final. And now, with a few minutes to go, plenty of time on the clock, they're just one unconverted score behind.
James Powell isn't leaving the field. He's back to his feet. keen to play a role in seeing this game out for Beths Grammar School.
Time on. Crouch.
We are just 5 minutes away from our first piece of silverware of the day. Who is going to have their hands on it? Beths Grammar School. Come again. And he was just down, but he times the pass well, and they did well to find Mansaray, who's come over onto this right wing, but the support's going to be needed, and Fofi got there and is trying to force that turnover, but the clear out is eventually a really good one. Sheese, Ticehurst, Grant, get it into a mall. Pocklington trying to lift it up. They've got more men on the left. Beths Grammar School, if they can use it. But crucial turnover for Pocklington as Beths Grammar School were getting up ahead of steam with ball in hand.
Well, they couldn't get the ball out there, but they had a 4-on-1 on the left-hand side before Pocklington responded.
You've got 3 minutes to go.
Come on, Beth, we're here!
You've got to match their numbers because they're putting the ball in.
So, Dave, as we reach the end of the game, a chance to reflect on perhaps who's made the most outstanding contribution.
Well, I don't think it'll be a surprise to anyone that Daniel Adamola gets man of the match. Tireless work, ball carrying when his team were up against it inside his own half, and that's without the four tries that he scored, including that spectacular solo effort, but still plenty of life in this game.
Pocklington knocked the ball forward in the tackle. The tackle was the reason it went forward, and it was strong. There's Niall Temple just giving some words to Daniel Adamola. It was interesting chatting to him. He said he was the coach for the first few years of this team, and then he's handed it on to Jake Eiderman. He says as soon as he's handed it on, they've taken them to the final. I said it's very much like that moment where you loosen a jar and give it to someone else who opens it. Someone else is going to get all the credit, but certainly Niall Temple has been big in the development of this team. Adamola. Now will he make the offload? He does. And now they find a bit more room to the left. Mansaray. Oh, he's going for the corner, Mansaray. Have they stopped him or has he got the ball down? Oh, it's a great try for Beths Grammar School. Ishmael Mansaray has got the ball down in the corner, and that might seal it.
Well, I think that's the one that puts this game to bed. Mansaray, he's done a lot harder work in defence than he's had to in attack in this final so far, but give him half an opportunity, and let's look at this finish. Again, it was a great pickup from the captain. Got round 10 and 12, and we sensed as soon as he got this offload away that danger could be afoot for Pocklington's. Picks it up, still plenty of work to do. Has a man outside him. There we go, that big fend there. Gets round the replacement and then shows strength to match the pace. Drags the defender over the line with him.
It's a really strong finish from Mansaray.
Just double check. Max, have you got time now?
Adamola, Mitchell, all combining well. Not an awful lot the likes of Oscar Hawksworth and Louis Sanguin could do to stop that try going over into the last, almost the last minute of the game.
Can you just confirm?
The referee is just checking how long left as we await the conversion.
Thank you. So we will have time for the kick.
It's another good effort, but Pocklington are very keen to
time off.
Try and get this one.
Thank you.
Quickly restarted. Well, certainly the coaches down below us are.
Well, they're emptying the bench here to give everyone a taste of finals rugby. And let's not forget that they scored that try with only 14 men on the field of play as well. What a huge relief and release to be able to have someone with that quality to get you out of trouble.
Josh Howard onto the field, as is Dan Cunningham, another one of those under 14s for Beths Grammar School.
Lads, you've got one too many players on the pitch.
And I think we're also going to see a replacement of Liam Sheese.
Okay, time on.
A And there is the other Sheese, Niall Sheese, who is taken out in the air.
Very careful with your timing, please.
Pocklington perhaps a little lucky that that man is not spending some time off the field. Kick down towards that touchline. Is it going to bounce before it goes in? That is excellent from Dan Mitchell. Puts the pressure on Pocklington. Asks the question of whether they can do it from their own 22. But at this stage, within the final minute, Beths Grammar School have got this job done.
Got 1 minute to go. Just under.
Kofi takes at the front. A ton of pressure on Sanguine. Our clock's gone red. We're on the referee's whistle. Taken in. And that will be that. The cheers tell you Beths Grammar School are the winners of the under 15 bowl final. And look what it means to them. Fantastic scenes here at Six Ways.
Yeah, absolutely, and they had to work hard for it too. But on days like today, you need your big players to step forward. Adam Ola, the captain, he got man of the match, and it wasn't just about those four tries that he scored. Whenever they needed him, he was there. Did it from all over the park and ably supported as well by some fantastic performances. I mentioned it in the first half, but very, very impressed with the character of Pocklington's. They could have let their heads drop and they could have been out of this final at any point, but they always managed to find big plays when they needed to. It wasn't quite enough to get them over the line, but an excellent final, over 60 points scored, and a great start to the day here at Six Ways.
Six tries for Beths Grammar School, five from Pocklington. We've certainly been treated in this opening game. If the rest of the day is going to be like that for our other finals, well, what an afternoon we will have. So full-time score in the under 15 bowl final of the NatWest Schools Cup, and it's Beths Grammar School 37, Pocklington School 27. Let's have a little look back at some of the highlights from our first match of the day.
Well, the chat before kickoff, Nick, was all about the Pocklington pack and the strength that they were going to show, but it was Beths and their big forwards that got us started. Here's Adamola's first try. Just, I think he caught Pocklington's a little bit unaware. Never sure who the big ball carriers were. Well, it was all about Adamola there. This is the try in the second half that nearly got Pocklington back into it. Great work up the blind side there. Pirouette from the kick. He's in pace to beat defenders and strength to carry them over the line. At that point, we thought Pocklington might be back in this, but of course it was the brilliant solo effort from Mansaray. Back to the first half then. It was the dangerous fullback Spike Weeks. We talked about him joining the attack late, nearly forced his way over the line there, but Pocklington, of course, holding him up. But then the space was on the blind side. Took one more phase. Again, it was the big winger. They often carry the ball like forwards these days, but he couldn't get over. But keep your eye on the captain here, number 8, Daniel Adamola, stays low. Good agility for a big man, and there's no stopping him from there, particularly with those upright body positions from Pocklington. This was the first show of, well, any kind of attack from Pocklington, and it was a lovely pick-up off the toes as well from the left winger, Ben Maycock. He was switched out to the wing just before kickoff, and well, with one try and one assist in the first half, that was a vindicated decision. Here's the big ball carrier Henry Hughes getting the first of his two tries.
Yeah, certainly showing Daniel Adamola anything you can do, I can do too.
Oh, absolutely. 8-on-8. And this was when Pocklington's got themselves right back into it just before half time. The kick into no man's land. Here's Maycock again on the ball, skipping by the tackle and then executing the 2-on-1 well to send in Sam Dyson. That was the first of his two tries, of course. We saw the second already. So at half-time, there was the penalty, of course, 20-15. We knew we were in for a great final then, and it carried on in the second half, much as it did in the first. This was that well-executed drive from the Beths pack. So disciplined. I think the coaches will be really pleased with the way that the pack managed to hold things together. That was a great release of pressure. And there Ademola just dots it down at the end. You can see a couple of heads drop in there from Pocklington's, but they soon picked themselves back up, and they had to, because they came under pressure again straight away. All that tough work Ademola had done. Again, Henry Hughes showing, I can do that too. Straight from the back of the scrum, taking some players over him, but this was the try of the match. Ademola picking it up. All of 75, 80 metres from the line. That was the halfway line. He just tiptoed over there. We'll let him off this early celebration. Look, the hand goes up, but thankfully for him, he didn't take his foot off the gas because he was under plenty of pressure there from Louis Sanguin. And not the most graceful of swan dives over. Pocklington defended valiantly, but Beth just kept coming and kept coming. Plenty of pressure on the line. No try that time. And of course, Pocklington blew a little bit of opportunity on their own as well. But here's Ademola again, taking defenders out. It was lateral running, but he was drawing defenders in, got the offload away. And as you pointed out, Nick, would that be the offload that sealed it? Yes, it was. Eventually, it went as far as Mansaray. We'll get to see it this time. Takes the centres and the outside half out of play. The space opened up on the left-hand side, and Mansaray there, even with the man outside him, gets a fend in there. Has a little check inside. Stays high, but he's powerful enough to finish the job. That made it 37-27. And Beths were good for that win.
They certainly were. Well, Dave Rogers, thank you very much indeed. And we can just see now the Beths Grammar School boys receiving their winners' medals. Pocklington School have received their runners-up medals. And you can see gleaming there in the centre of the picture the under-15 NatWest Schools Cup bowl waiting to be lifted by our man of the match and the skipper of Beths Grammar School, Daniel Ademola. Lawrence Tysurst there, who just goes through, also a man who had a really good game. Pocklington sportingly applauding every man who's come through from Beths as well. Photo opportunities. Say this is the champagne moment. It is, of course, under-15s rugby. But many congratulations to Beths Grammar School, who've overcome Pocklington in the under-15 bowl final. Congratulations also to Jake Eideman and Niall Temple for their input on the match. Beths Grammar School will enjoy every moment of this, and so they should. Well, they're continuing to enjoy every request of them that's made from the photos, whether it's officially at the presentation board or whether it's from their schoolmates over the course of the afternoon. We hope you've enjoyed our coverage of the under-15 bowl final. Of course, our day of rugby continues, but for now, from Six Ways, it's a very good afternoon.
chance here with the corner. Is he going to get there? He will do. Oh, the try! Into the Warwick 22, come Dulwich. And Zigu, is he there? Dulwich College, the dynasty continues.
Blake Edwards.